हेलो वेलकम बैक माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10th. डियर स्टूडेंट आई एम राजेंद्र राय बायोलॉजी टीचर फ्रॉम LPM पब्लिक स्कूल गोरखपुर. डियर स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस सीरीज यू आर लर्निंग द डिजिटल वीडियो ऑफ द चैप्टर आवर एनवायरनमेंट एंड आवर एनवायरनमेंट प्रीवियसली यू हैव सीन अबाउट द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स अबाउट द सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द इकोसिस्टम like primary producer, producer, consumer and decomposers. So further, my dear students, let us see about the different types of the ecosystems, different types of the ecosystems in the world. And before that, let us see about the functions of the ecosystem. Functions of ecosystem. So see how the ecosystem function and how the ecosystem will be helpful for the different types of the organisms or human being on the earth. So my dear students, solar energy trapped by the autotrophic organism. As you know, the energy that coming that is trapped by the autotrophic organism like plants and algae etc. The autotrophic organism prepare food and they are called the producer. These organic materials are used by the heterotrophic organisms as a food and some of the material are returned to the environment in the form of the excreta while the rest is returned to the environment when they die. That is done by the decomposers. The dead body of an organism is decomposed by a certain group of the organism known as the decomposers. Another group of the organism called transformer change these compounds into a suitable compound which can be reutilized by the autotrophic organism. So these are the different functions of the ecosystem. And now let us see that how many major ecosystems that are present in the world. So now let us see the ecosystems in the world, and that is the natural ecosystem. Number one, that is the natural ecosystem. Dear student, this natural ecosystem is the ecosystem like aquatic ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem. Aquatic ecosystem means freshwater ecosystem. Aquatic and terrestrial. Aquatic and terrestrial ecosystem. Dear students, the aquatic ecosystem, that is freshwater, marine and estuarine water ecosystem. This is of three types: freshwater, marine and third is that is estuarine ecosystem. My dear students, freshwater ecosystem like pond, rivers, streams, lakes, etc. are the example of the freshwater ecosystem. While sea, that is the marine ecosystem, and estuarine, that means water having the intermediate salinity within a range of 0.5% to 3.5% due to the intermixing of sea water with fresh water entering into the sea as a result of land drainage is called estuarine. Means when the rivers going into the sea, so the sea water get returned to this river. So this kind of the mixed water, that is marine with the fresh water, is called estuarine. So there is another type of the aquatic ecosystem. Marine means sea, this is sea, and fresh water ecosystem, that is pond, lake, pond, lake, river, and streams, etc. My dear students, come to the terrestrial ecosystem. Terrestrial ecosystems are the forest, forest of tundra, tundra biome, taiga biome, and temperate forest biome. There are several terrestrial systems: tundra, tundra, taiga, temperate forest, and others are tropical, grassland, and desert. Tropical, grassland, and lastly the desert ecosystem. So tundra means that is the extremely cold area, and little bit less cold area, that is taiga. Temperate means neither cold nor warm area are the forest. These are the forest ecosystem. And tropical means that is the heart. This is the subtropical, this is the tropical. Tropical means the area which is situated at the equator of the earth are called tropical ecosystem. Grassland means the grazing animals, for that is for the grazing animals. And desert means the deserts are having different types of the ecosystem. So dear students, these are the natural ecosystems which are found across the world. And now come to the artificial type of the artificially you can see artificial. Dear students, this artificial ecosystem, best example is the aquarium, that is a small fish house, and that you can maintain this small ecosystem inside your home. That is the artificial ecosystem, which is having some grass, microorganism, fishes, water. So this aquarium, that is the artificial ecosystem which you can create inside your home. So these are the some examples of the ecosystem that are natural and artificial. My dear students, after this ecosystem come to the, this ecosystem are having the different component, biotic and abiotic. And let us see about the interactive components of the ecosystem. Interactive components of the ecosystem, they form a series of the food chain. They form a series of the food chain, and that food chain can be defined as the, this food chain, that is a food chain, that is a link chain, that starts from the plants and it end up to the top trophic level consumers. And these animal and plants link together and they preserve at the different trophic level. And the relationship between the various living being in an ecosystem in the form of chain based purely on the feeding habit. Therefore, the food chain can be explained as the linking of different organisms based on
their food feeding, their feeding habits. So this linking is called the food chain.
Linking in between the different organisms that is based on their feeding habit is called food chain. My dear students, this food chain is of several types. Like there are in the forest, in the grassland, in the pond, and in the ocean, there are different types of the food chains are there, and these food chains are based on the this food chain that is having the different types means. So a food chain that represents a unidirectional for single directional or single directional transfer of energy. So that called the linear food chain. So this is the number one, and different types of the food chains are there. Number one, grazing food chain or predator food chain. Grazing food chain, different types of the food chains are there. Number one, grazing food chain. Grazing food chain. Number two, grazing food chains means that is the different types of the animals. Different types of the animals. इसको बोलते हैं predators food chain. So like the insect that depend upon the grass, and that insect, frog, snake, eagle. So this is the linear food chain, and that is called the grazing food chain. Second is that is in the forest. Forest food chain means grass, herbs, and trees in the forest. Forest means grass, herbivores, amphibs, and finally these amphibs get hunted by the birds. So this is the example of the forest food chain, and third one that is in the grassland, grasshopper. This is the grazing or grassland, and in pond there are several pond, ocean. Parasitic food chains are there, saprophytic food chains are there, and detritus food chains are there. So dear students, in this food chain, in the pond and ocean, there are several types of the food chains are there, and that is having this planktons. These planktons are either phyto or zoo. So the microorganisms like bacteria, protozoan, etc. comes under the zooplankton, and small unicellular plants, they comes under the phytoplanktons. They may be found in the pond, ocean, lakes, etc. to maintain the aquatic food chain. So this will be the aquatic food chain. This is the third one, that is the aquatic food chain. And
parasitic food chain, parasitic food chain. Then fifth is, that is the saprophytic food chain. And lastly, but not least, that is the detritus food chain. Detritus means the decomposed body of the producer is called detritus. Detritus food chain. Detritus. Detritus means decomposed material. Decomposed material. So decomposed materials are for the factor of the detritus food chain. So by this way, these are the different types of the food chains which are found in different types of the ecosystems, whether they are forest ecosystem, freshwater ecosystem, pond ecosystem, marine ecosystem, etc. So my dear students, for today this is enough. If you like this video, please put a like. If you dislike this video, put a dislike. And if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a good day.